I'm Tammy McMahan, and I go to Harvest Bible Chapel in Elgin. I grew up in Ohio. My parents were super active in the community, and in kindergarten, I accepted Christ. And from that point on, we just went to church every time the door was open. So we were in Sunday school, we did Awanas. I became a leader in my own youth group and ended up going to Taylor University. I met my husband, Mark, and after 6 years, we had our first child, Alex. And after that, we had 5 children under 7. And life was all about them. I was a mom and just loved it. Everything we did, we tried to do to teach them to come to know the Lord. I mean, my greatest prayer for my own children and any children is that He would be their refuge and their hope. I had learned from the Lord that His heart was for the poor, the orphan, and the widow. And we saw that in Ruth, and we saw the gleaning principle that we were to take from our abundance and give to those who were in need. And I specifically remember praying to the Lord, Lord, I really don't know any orphans. And you know, I didn't even really know anyone who had been widowed. And it just hit me that, oh my goodness, this is us. This is me. I was the poor in spirit. I was a widow before I came to know the Lord, and that I was an orphan until He adopted me. And so I had so been convicted. We were sitting in church on Orphan Sunday in 2015. And they just took one Sunday morning to focus on the need of orphans and the adopted. There's a real focus that the modern day orphan is the foster child because they'd been pulled from their home and they had lost their family and they needed care. So after that service, I just looked over at Mark and I said, oh, honey, what if we could just help with respite?
We got to thinking about whether we should be involved. Many of the thoughts around being a foster parent circle around, is that for couples that can't have their own children? Is it for empty nesters, so to speak? And this was probably not for us, right? I mean, we never considered that at that point. But as Tammy and I were talking about it, it just made sense. It was a calling. It was something that the Lord had laid on our hearts right then to say, we can do this. And so we started walking down through the steps, got the licensing, the certification.
And that began our journey. From that, we really focused on sibling groups. We had anywhere from 2 to 6 children in our home.
Those are the most difficult groups of children for the foster system to keep intact. Families can often take one child. They may even be able to take 2 children, but when you've got a sibling group of 3, 4, or 5, then you start getting into a very small group of families that know how to logistically handle that many children. Having 5 of our own, many children was not a fear for us.
The idea for the Ruth Project came up because we realized so many people were giving up in fostering. And I knew that we had a body of Christ that surrounded us, but we knew that 50 to 75% of first-time foster parents gave up after the first year. And we thought, you know what? We can help so that people can continue this. So it was just an idea. And Lynn came to me and she said, Tammy, I know that you've talked about doing a Ruth Project thing and helping foster families. What if we did something to close our Bible study time? And I said, hey, how about we do a shower? And all the women at our Bible study in Elgin dropped off clothes, diapers, supplies. We filled a half a storage unit and then the word started to spread. The word of mouth from that drive-through shower filled 6 storage units full of clothing, diaper boxes, high chairs, everything. And that's how we launched the Ruth Project.
Yeah. It has been dramatically impactful to our family to watch literally God at work.
Now today, we have had 23 children in our home and just had an amazing, amazing journey of watching the Lord change children's lives and families. We've had many parents that will bring them to a visit and they're all like, what happened? These are totally different children. And I know what that is. That's the love of Christ. And it's just such an easy way to say, yeah, that's what the Lord has done for me.